Welcome to the low-speed Windtunnel laboratory of TU Delft. In the lectures, I talked about a laminar and turbulent flow and transition. In a few days, our second-year students will do a practical with this setup here, this simple setup, and it gives me the nice opportunity to show you these flow characteristics in a test. Now, let me first explain a little bit about this test setup. It is an airfoil model with pressure holes. And these holes, these pressure holes, are connected to this manometer here. But the model is also connected to the overhead balance system. What I have here is a stethoscope. This is a small tube connected to a microphone, and the microphone is connected to an amplifier. Now, a laminar boundary layer has a nice flow, smooth in layers, and if you put the microphone in there, you can hear practically nothing. But if you look at the turbulent boundary layer, then the movement of the air particles is chaotic. And that is something that you actually can hear. So let's do that.
We will first start up the wind tunnel at zero angle of attack at a relatively low speed so that we can hear the sound of the boundary layer. It is a laminar airfoil. At this wind speed, the transition location is at about 70% of the chord. We will now increase the angle of attack to about 5 degrees. As you can see, or perhaps I should say as you can hear, the transition location has shifted to the mid-chord position. The next angle of attack is 8 degrees. The transition has now arrived at the leading edge at about 5% of the chord. As I explained in one of the lectures, a nice way of learning something about the flow over the airfoil is the fluorescent oil technique. The model is painted with oil to which a fluorescent dye has been added. And if we look at it with a UV lamp, we will see the effect of wall friction. And as you know by now, a turbulent boundary layer has higher shear stress than a laminar one. We will start at the Reynolds number of 1 million at 2 degrees incidence. This is a view on the controls of the tunnel. The upper left screen shows the tunnel parameters, such as temperature, air density, barometric pressure, and wind speed. As you can see, the model has a chord of 240 millimeters. For a Reynolds number of 1 million, we need a wind speed of about 62 meters per second. In the lower left corner, you can see the angle of attack settings. The right screen contains the six balances of the mechanical balance system. Now back to the oil flow pictures. The laminar boundary layer has an increasingly lower shear stress as it flows over the airfoil. At some point, the oil drips down due to gravity. The relatively black area behind the vertical dripping oil is the place where transition took place. The turbulent boundary layer has a high friction and drags the oil with it to the trailing edge. There was a small particle in the oil that disturbed the flow and caused the turbulent wedge behind it. The angle of attack is now increased to a much higher angle and transition takes place close to the leading edge, although that is difficult to see, so that almost the entire airfoil upper surface is turbulent. I have painted the airfoil again at the same angle, and we see transition taking place around 10%. The oil reaches the trailing edge, and there is no separation. Now the angle of attack increases again. At the leading edge, transition moves forward, more oil is taken along by the flow, while at the same time, at the trailing edge, separation starts with a large area of reversed flow that begins at about 20% of the cord. From the readings of the balance, you can see that the flow is highly unsteady at these angles. If we now decrease the angle to the value we started with, you see the normal pattern again, with transition around 60% of the chord. Now what about this manometer? This multi-manometer has 200 tubes which are read by a bar with fiber optic cells that record the level of the liquid in the tubes. This is a fairly old-fashioned instrument, and since many years we use fast electronic pressure scanners, but it is quite accurate and very instructive. At the left-hand side, you see 25 pressures on the upper surface, followed by about the same number on the lower surface. The second bank of tubes contains the total pressure in the wake, measured by a wake rake with 50 tubes. If we increase the angle of attack from 0 to 8 degrees, you see the pressure on the suction side becoming more negative, so the liquid rises in the tubes, and those on the lower side going up. Close off, especially for you, I took my iPhone and made some shots from inside the contraction of the tunnel, upstream of the test section.